so I have come back into the woods to locate the snakes and turtles to just collect temperature readings. You know, it is the middle of winter, they're not going to be active, but I wanted to give you a full report on what I found. So I'm down here at Utsunati's den location. And first thing, I turned on the radio and I received no signal from his transmitter. And I thought, well, maybe it's due to the cold, because it has been very cold for the last week, with temperatures below zero at night with the chill factor. Did you hear that? One pulse. The cold weather, I believe, is affecting the battery life on the transmitter. So I'm getting one pulse every 50 seconds. That's got me worried about the transmitter more than the snake. Utsunati is hibernating, if you've been following these videos and their status. He's hibernating directly under the snow right here. Okay, so I don't think I have to worry about him. You know, millions of years of evolution has programmed his genetics, his DNA, his whole biology on how to survive in this type of situation. And hopefully he's okay. He's been able to withstand the cold weather. But then again, there's the possibility that he wasn't deep enough and the cold got him. But again, I'm leaning more towards the technology. Even though it is the best technology that I can get for this this rattlesnake study, there's still the chance that you know, the battery life, although the batteries are near the end of their two-year lifespan, I think the cold's really affecting them. Hopefully they'll last long enough to let us see Utsunati emerge from hibernation this spring from his den, which right now is pretty much frozen in, as you can see. Although we are going to, again, set up the trail cameras, monitoring his den, and hopefully we'll get to see some video of Utsunati crawling out into the forest in about 2 months. Until that time, I'm going to keep checking on his transmitter and see, you know, see what's going on here. Hopefully it's not going to die before he emerges. Had me worried there for a little while there, Mr. Utsunati. I wonder what it's like underground in his chamber right now. Hear that? No, it's not a Sasquatch knocking on a tree. It's probably a pileated woodpecker searching for ants or grubs or something inside of a hollow tree just over there. So only time will tell. Let's go find Zoe. I'm not getting any signal on Zoe's transmitter either. It could be that this cold has drastically affected the battery life on these transmitters. Let's go up and find her and find out. Okay, well, it looks like Zoe is still in her hibernaculum. Her transmitter is working. It's the signal is strong, as you can hear, but the range is greatly reduced. It's a lot lower power than it's normally operating at, I believe, and I think that's probably due to the fact that the transmitter is 2 years old and it's been very cold. So it's reduced the output of the transmitter, I believe. So that's why I wasn't able to pick it up 50 yards down the hill, where normally I would pick it up just fine. Let's go find the turtles and see how they're doing. All right, well, I just checked on Jimmy Irwin. He is underneath this mountain laurel shrub. Can't see him because he's under the leaves, hibernating. He's doing fine. His temperature's good, soil temperature. And his transmitter's pulsing away just like it should, no problems at all. Interesting thing to note, the soil temperature here is 43 degrees. Down on the other side of the mountain, over that way, where I just came from, where I checked the rattlesnakes, their soil temperature was 32. Now, of course, there was a coating of snow. It's the northwest side of the mountain. Jimmy here, where he's hibernating, he's very smart in that he picked an area that gets some good sun late in the day, especially as the sun's going down, as you can see behind me, and that really helps warm him up before the hard night. So let's go check on Catherine, see how she's doing. Okay, so I'm down at Catherine's hibernation spot, and the radio is getting no signal at all. I've tried several different frequencies around the frequency that her transmitter transmits at, and I'm getting nothing. Gone up and down 5 to 7 points, nothing. So let's try one more time. Nothing. This transmitter, I attached this transmitter to Catherine in 2013, late in the year. And it supposedly had a 3-year battery life, and I was going to replace it this year. But I'm getting nothing. So I think the cold has affected this transmitter just like it did Usanati's. One thing I need to make sure of, though, is that Catherine is still underground here, because there's no reason she should have moved, although she could have been dug up and carried off by an animal or something. So let's check and see. Now, if she's here, I'm not going to dig her up. I just want to make sure that she is still here. And if she is, I'll be able to come back and replace her transmitter before the end of the year. I mean, before the end of the winter. Just want to make sure she's down here. Doesn't look like it's been disturbed. And you see this stick? I put this stick here. This is one of the sticks I put here. I put several sticks here, actually, back in the fall to note where she was. Feeling around for her shell, getting nothing. So maybe she's moved up here. There's a lot of holes underground. Maybe some turtle movements. Here's, I think, her chamber where she was before. Getting nothing, but there is a turtle-sized hole right here. It really has me worried. My hand is getting so cold. Oh wait, I found her. Okay, she's still here. We'll stuff a bunch of leaves down in that hole. Good, she's still here, but it looks like her transmitter has failed. Okay. Oh, my hand is cold. Well, I feel a little bit better now. At least she's still here. Nothing carried her off. But that means that her transmitter has failed. I'm going to have to come back probably in March on a warm day and pull Catherine out, put her transmitter back on, and then put her back in the ground. I'll use the same technique I used on Jimmy, using a quick curing epoxy. That way I don't have to take her out of the woods for any time at all. I can put the transmitter on, it will set up, and then when she comes out in the spring, I can take the tape off of the transmitter. I can just leave the tape on it with her underground. So that's good to know that she's still here, but it's the weather. It's this really cold weather. It's really affecting the battery life. And that is part of this type of research. You just have to just have to put up with it and adapt to it and go on, just like these turtles and snakes do when they're subjected to cold weather. So that's what we'll do. Okay, so I'm over at the Sky Valley study site now, tracking the reptiles at this location. And right now I'm gonna go look for Splinter and Paula Journeys, who are hibernating about 100 feet apart. Boy, the woods are so different this time of year. Obviously because there's 8 inches of snow on the ground. I'm getting a really weak signal. I'm not even picking it up now, but it's in this direction, as it should be. Okay, so here I am. This is Splinter's hibernaculum, somewhere underground in front of me in this little hill area. It's a little hump in the woods, open to the sky. So it gets some pretty good solar radiation on days when the sun's out. So that helps keep his hibernaculum a little bit warmer. Although today I don't think it's very warm. So let me do some data collection and find out my temperature readings for the day, and then I'll go on and find Paula Journeys. It's really good to know that he's still here, that his transmitter is still transmitting. That makes me feel good about this unit, and I still need to check the other three reptiles at this study site to verify that all their transmitters are working. So let's do that. Okay, so I have collected my data for Splinter the rat snake, and now I have changed the frequency over to Paula Journeys, the box turtle, her frequency, getting a good strong pulse, and she is just on the other side of the creek. Okay, so Paula Journeys, the box turtle, is directly under the snow, and her signal sounds nice and strong. We've collected our data. We've collected the data on Splinter the rat snake over on the other side of the creek, about 100 feet from here. And both transmitters sound to be in excellent condition, transmitting strongly. So now all we need to do is go find Apollo and Shelly Echo, and we will have located all of the turtles and snakes in the Turtle and Snake Tracks projects. So let's make our way back out of the snow-covered forest. I wonder if I'm gonna find any Bigfoot tracks out here. Probably only my Bigfoot tracks, sadly. It'd be nice to actually find a real Bigfoot, if such a creature exists. I do see some animal tracks over here, though. Take a look. What do we have here? And small dog tracks or coyote tracks. Could be Searsha. For those of you that have been here before and visited this site, you'll know of Searsha, the little black and tan mountain feist who spends most of her life in search of rodents of all shapes, sizes, and descriptions. And she's a very accomplished hunter. right, so I have Apollo's signal, and it's really nice and strong. So let's go find him. Yeah, there's the rhododendron that we found Apollo outstretched on back in the fall of 2014. And he is actually just down here. He's underground, right in front of me, underneath these old rhododendrons. So it looks like his signal is as strong as it was the last time I was here. Pulsing at exactly the same rate as Master Splinter's transmitter, so I believe everything is in great shape with these two guys. Okay, so as you can hear, Apollo's transmitter is pulsing just like Splinter's. So they're pulsing at the same width, the sound's nice and very strong, so I don't think I have to worry about their transmitters, unlike Utsunati's, who seems to be dying. And it looks like the first turtle we've located here, Shelly Echo, is just fine. Now we need to go find Paula Journeys and see how she's doing. And hopefully she's going to be in good shape as well. So, so far so good here at the Sky Valley study site. So I'm looking for Shelly Echo. I'm getting a really interesting signal here. This is a very strange signal. I could be getting a bounce. No, it's not a bounce. That's the signal. Mm-hmm. She's in this clump of mountain laurel somewhere. All right, let's see. She's right about here. Right here. Right in front of me, under the snow. All right. Okay, so that's where Paula Journeys is. Up on this little knoll, not too far from where she hibernated last year. About 60 yards, really. It's kind of far, actually, if you're a box turtle, especially a box turtle that is missing both or two of its feet. Okay, so I've located all of the turtles and snakes in the Turtle Tracks and Snake Tracks reptile conservation projects. Everybody's doing exactly what I expected, sleeping the winter away under this beautiful blanket of snow. Spring's not far. It's almost March. So it won't be long before we're going to see some activity. We're going to see the turtles and the snakes moving out of their wintering, overwintering areas. And who knows what they're going to do this year. You know, they're probably going to follow some similar patterns that they followed in previous years, but hopefully there'll be something new, because there always is. So that's it for winter 2015. Snake and Turtle Tracks reports, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.